Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Floss Marketing School. In a previous video, I was explaining you about what's inside a laptop. Today, I will show you what's inside a smartphone. So, here is a smartphone that I have. Actually, I bought it on eBay for 20 euros. And as you can see, it's really in a poor, in a very poor state. So that's why I just got it for just 20 euros in order to open it up and see what's inside. Because probably the issue that you are going through is that your smartphone is kind of a baby, so you probably don't want to open it like this. First of all, before starting to open it, what you need to have is one of those kits, or at least something equivalent, because the point is that if you ruin one of your screws like this, you will have, unfortunately, to dig within the cover of your smartphone, and you may damage by digging it within some components, and you may of course damage even more your smartphone. So in order to open a smartphone such as this, what I advise you is of course to get the different object in order to open it up, but as well have a look through different video tutorial in order to know what you are going through. You can just enter your device name and you'll probably get a specific tutorial. Just to let you know that I never opened a smartphone before. I just did it this morning just by watching a video, and as you can see, or as you will see within this video, I went pretty far and pretty well. So already removed all those screws for the sake of this tutorial in order to make it faster. So I got this smartphone without the rear cover, so that's why I don't have one, but normally you have a rear cover, so you just need to unplug it, and when you do so, you will have your smartphone, which will look like this. So in fact, the first part that you need to remove, so I'm just gonna do it like this, first part that you have to remove and that you're probably able to do on your own is the battery. So as you can see, it's exactly like in a laptop. You have an individual battery that you can remove straight away. Okay, once you remove the battery, you need to get rid of the screws. So in my case, I just had six screws, which were those small gray one, so I just remove them. Once you remove them, what you need to have is something like this, or to use even your nails, though I prefer to use those. Always use plastic against plastic in order to not destroy the cover, and you just need to push it like this on the corner, and once you have done so, you can remove in fact this first part. Okay, once you remove this this first part, you will get something similar to this. And here it starts to be interesting, because you see already the first components of your smartphones, which are, for example, here, this is where you put your SIM card. So this is everything which deal with the possibility to make phone calls. And in the case of the device that I have here, I can remove it. This one was a bit tricky because it was pasted here. So I had actually to push it around the corner in order to remove it. And what is interesting here is, as you can see, I get this small square, and in fact this small square is exactly the same thing that you can see with external components that you want to plug to the mother card for a laptop. And that's exactly the same thing with smartphones. Yep, I just need to remove it. This one, yep, peacefully like this. And in fact, what happened is that those given square, you just need to plug them like this in order, whoops, sorry for that, in order to have them stick to your cards in my case, and not just, yes, okay, oops. Okay, just need to put them like this. You will feel that actually they are sticky, and then in order to remove them back, you just need to use either tool like this, or either you need to use your nails in order to remove them. So to say, let's imagine that you broke this given component. All you need to do is just to look through the internet about the serial number of this given GSM component, and then you can in fact change it out exactly like for a laptop. So this is the main board. As you can see, you can remove as well here. This is the, I think this is the sensor, the accelerometer. This is the camera. So you can easily remove, for example, the camera. You just need to unplug this part and then just buy this serial number in order to change it back. And here you get the hard drive, which is a 16 hard drive component. The thing is, as you can see, I have no SIM, I have no SD card, so actually I just have to rely on those 16 gigabytes. I know that I cannot go above this given volume. Here is the micro processor of the smartphone. So as you can see, it's exactly like a laptop. It's just that the components are smaller or are additional. For example, this one, you don't have it on a laptop. The GSM as well, you don't have it on the laptop. Here is, for example, the speaker. Here is the semiconductor. Here is, I think this one is for the screen. Oh no, this one is for to connect to the main board. But you have the screen somewhere else, somewhere here. And of course, in the next tutorial, what I try to do is I will try to show you how you can change the screen, how you can give a second life to your smartphone. And I hope I will be able to show you how you can change the operating system. If we move back actually to my laptop screen, so have a look on tutorial like this. Just enter the serial number of your smartphone and you will see example of people will guide you through how to open it properly. And once more, as well, what is interesting is if you would like to change the different components of your smartphone, all you need to know is the serial number. If you cannot catch the serial number because it's written too small, well, what you can do is that actually you can take them in picture. I mean, in my case, I have very bad eyes, so I wasn't able to read the serial number on the mother card or any other component, so I just took them in picture, and then after that you can zoom on them and you can know in fact what is the hard drive serial number, what is the semiconductor number, and then after you can easily check on the internet what is the price of those individual components and how much you should spend in order to change those components. I hope it helps you understand a little bit more what's inside smartphones and see that there is not much difference between smartphones and laptops. Thanks for watching.